We'll be with you in a moment. Good morning, everybody. Good afternoon, good evening, whatever time zone you're in. This is the day that the Lord has made, and I choose to rejoice. Hallelujah. Venus Diaz, Vanny, God bless you. We praise the Lord for all the listeners, some in the United States and Mexico and different parts. We love you and we appreciate you. We pray God's blessing upon you as we gather again today in the name of the Lord. It is a great day to be alive, and I'm going to be talking to you today, how can we store up treasures in heaven? Glory. Yes, how we can store up treasures in heaven. Let me, before I get started here, one of the things a lot of people don't realize is that God, number one, the Bible says, is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. Also, he rewards his children. Now, we are so humble, we don't think that God is going to do that. But we have to go with what the Word of God says. And I want to share this with you today. I believe that more Christians would do more things if they would know that they were going to be rewarded for being good. Hallelujah. And so we're going to share a little bit about that. And I think if more people would realize that, it wouldn't be so difficult for pastors or for leaders to encourage people to do something for the Lord. Because we are going to be rewarded. This is what the Word of God says. Now, here's a good one right here in Matthew, the 6th chapter, verse 19. Matthew 6:19, it says this. Do not lay up your treasures on earth. You see, one time there was a man who died, and all the relatives came to see what the lawyer was going to tell them, how much money they was going to get when this guy died. And so the lawyer came out of the office, and the people said, how much did he leave? And the lawyer said, he left it all. He didn't take none of it with him. And I have never seen a hearse that has a trailer or a U-Haul truck behind it. So when we die, we don't take anything with us. Okay? This is what the Word of God says. So do not lay up treasures on earth, where moth and rust destroy, and where thieves break in and steal. Verse 20 says, but lay up your treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust destroys, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there also is your heart. I want to share with you today that we can store up treasures in heaven. That's right. We can store it up. Jesus said in his word that he commanded us that our hearts should not be on this earth. But he said, where your treasure is, there also is your heart. So you can tell where a person's heart is by looking at their checkbook and to see where they give their money to. We can find out where their treasure is. We can find out where their treasure is, where they spend their time, and what they do with their time. Everybody gets 24 hours a day, and we need to allot a certain portion of that in the kingdom of God. So the Bible mentions rewards that await the believer who faithfully served God in Matthew 10:41. It's a great reward. It's promised to those even that have been persecuted for the name of Jesus. Now, there are various crowns. I want you to go to 2 Timothy. 2 Timothy, where there are various crowns. I want you to go there with me now, if you would please. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 8. It says this in the Word of God. Finally, there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give to me on that day, and not to me only, but also to all those who love his appearing. So God is storing up wonderful things for the born-again believer. And there will be a fire and it will destroy a person's house. That's sad. That's a bummer, you know. But listen to me. What we do for God will never be destroyed, never be burned up, never be stolen. So where should we be putting our treasure? Our treasure should not be on the things of this world, but our treasure should be going before us in the name of the Lord. So we are to treasure the Lord Jesus Christ most of all. When Jesus is our treasure, we will commit our resources, our money, our time, and our talent to his work in this world. Every dollar that you have given in the kingdom of God is recorded, and you will get your just reward. Everything that you've ever done for the kingdom of God, or how you have blessed somebody. The Bible says that even when we give somebody a drink of water, that it's recorded. So how is your balance sheet today? Is it full with good works? Now, we don't do good works to get to heaven. We do good works because we love Jesus. So we're not going to go to heaven because of all the things that I have done. No, I'm going to heaven only because of the blood of Jesus Christ. But after I commit my life to God, I want to work for him and I want to bless his work. And so our motivation is what's so important. Do we do things so that we be seen of men, or that we get some kind of award down here? Then that's it, you know? And so when we work for God, we don't want anybody tooting our horn. We don't want to toot our own horn because we're not doing it for people. We're doing it as unto the Lord. So when someone comes up to me and says, Gordon, that was a great sermon, immediately you will hear me say, praise the Lord. I don't want any of it to stay with me, but I'm going to direct the praise to heaven. And so if you do something good and somebody compliments you, immediately say, thank Jesus, praise the Lord, God is good. And so none of it stays here, but it all goes up there for his glory. Now, Paul encourages the servants that God has an eternal reward for those who are motivated to serve God. Oh, I like this. Whatever you do, work at with all your heart as working for the Lord. So when you're working for somebody on this earth, and you have a job, you work as you're working for the Lord, that God's name will be glorified. And so this is what we do. The Bible says, since you know that you will receive an inheritance from the Lord as a reward. It is the Lord Jesus Christ that we're serving. When I'm pastoring or when I'm evangelizing, I'm not doing it for the people. I'm not working for the people. I am working as unto the Lord. And so if whatever job that you might have, if you're a cook, you're a truck driver, you're a taxi driver, whatever, you work as unto the Lord, and he will give you just reward. When we live sacrificially for Jesus' sake and serve him. By serving the body of Christ, we are storing up treasures in heaven. I believe the church needs to be more motivated. When you and I will get the vision that when we do something on this earth for the kingdom of God and for the glory of God, we're going to get a reward. That should be a motivation. This is only what the Bible says. If anyone, like I mentioned before in Matthew 10:42, if anyone gives even a cup of cold water to one of those little ones who is my disciples, truly I tell you, that person will certainly not lose their reward in Matthew 10:42. So there are visible things that we do. I'm a preacher. I'm a teacher. I'm an evangelist. I take those gifts that God has given to me. There are people who are singers. There are people who play musical instruments. Those gifts have been given to these people by God. So now I take those gifts that God has given to me, and I lift them up to the Lord, and I say, these gifts that you have given to me, I lift them up to you, and we're going to be rewarded. There are people that are singing in nightclubs and bars. They're singing in Hollywood. They have a talent. They have a voice. That voice came from God, but they're using it for the devil, and they'll not be rewarded for that according to the kingdom of God. The Lord will be a faithful rewarder for us as we serve him in Hebrews 6:10. Our ministries differ. Some people serve the Lord in one area, being a nurse or a doctor or a truck driver. We wouldn't have anything in this house if we didn't have truck drivers. And then there is the person, you know, that is at the grocery store, and they're stacking the shelves. And then there's the lady or the man who is the cashier. I thank them, especially now with the problems that we're having around the world. And I say to them, thank you for coming to work, because if you wouldn't be here, I couldn't buy the groceries. And so, but whatever we do it as unto the Lord. I believe when we get that vision, we're going to be a better truck driver. We're going to be a better teacher. We're going to be a better taxi driver. We're going to be a better cook. Everything is going to be better because we are not working for those people that we see, but we're working and doing unto the Lord. Amen? Because we know that he's the one that rewards. Now here in Matthew 19:16-30, the rich man who loved his money more than he loved God, and God pointed it out to him. He said, if you want to follow me, give all your money away. Well, Ufa, he had a lot of money. He did not want to leave that money. You see, his treasure was not in heaven. His treasure was on this earth, and he walked away. There are men that have been called of God to do a work for him, and they had great resources. And God says, get rid of it all and follow me. Leave that $100,000 job. Leave that big mansion. Leave that position and follow me. And they wouldn't do it. They would not do it. And things don't go good for you and I when we do not obey God. We are warned not to lose our full reward by following false teachers and the isms of this world. The treasures that await the child of God, listen to me, will far outweigh any trouble that you're in today, any inconvenience, any persecution that you might face in Romans 8:18. We can serve the Lord with all of our heart, knowing, listen to me, that God is keeping score and he rewards us abundantly. He is gracious. 1 Corinthians 15:58. Always give fully to the work of God, because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. Maybe you're working. Maybe you're doing things for God. Let's go back to my mother, who had an eighth grade education, who loved God all the years that I knew my mother. There was never a doubt that this woman did not know God. She taught our family to serve the Lord. And out of that came one deacon, one Sunday school teacher, or one teacher in the public system, and then two preachers. What a reward my mother received when she went to heaven, because she was a faithful wife, a faithful mother. And so those of you that are raising children and you are being faithful to God and you are raising that child for the glory of God, oh, hallelujah. I remember my mother came to hear me preach, and she's crying while I'm preaching. And I walked up to her and I said, "Mom, was my sermon that bad that you had to cry all the way through it?" And she said, "No, Gordon, it wasn't bad. I remember the nights that I spent in prayer for you." You see, my mother would not go to sleep until I got into my room and I was safe. I hate to say this, but several times I was drunk and I don't remember going across the bridge to my dad's farm. Hear me now. My mother prayed me home. She prayed and interceded for me. And she was not crying of depression or anything like that. She was crying of joy. I want to encourage you as a mom and a dad today to continue to pray and to speak life into your children. There was another man that I worked with, and I was away from God at the time. His name was Merlin Jenner. He was very tall, like a string bean, and he was a born-again believer. And he knew that I was not doing well in my life, and he would always greet me with a smile and tell me how much he loved me and how much God loved me. Oh, I'm telling you, that man prayed for me, and today he is going to receive his reward as he prayed for me. People that have given into this ministry financially and with your prayers, you're going to receive a reward. I couldn't give it to you. No way. But God rewards those people. So sometimes we feel like we're insignificant, that we're like nobody, like we're not important. But wait a minute. If you are doing the will of God and you are doing what God says for you to do, then you will get your just reward. We are rewarded not because how famous we are. We are rewarded because we obeyed God and we did what he said. Last story. There is a man that he's in heaven now. He went to Bible school in Minneapolis, Minnesota. And he went to Bible school, and his name is Brother Dutton. He went to Bible school. Everybody else was being commissioned. "I'm going to Africa. I'm going to Texas to pastor. I'm going to Louisiana." And everybody was going somewheres, but he had not received an assignment. And he went home to a place called Vail, South Dakota. And in that city of 300 people, he started or bought a lumber yard. And he was an honest man. He was a tither. He was a giver. And he sent thousands and thousands of dollars into the kingdom of God. People would drive 50, 60 miles out of the way to come to that little bitty place in Vail, South Dakota, to buy their lumber. They passed up other lumber yards, but they came to his lumber yard. He was a faithful man. Nobody hardly knows him. But when he entered into heaven, there was some shouting going on. And they'll run up to him and say, "Mr. Dutton, it was because of your finances that you sent the missionary to Czechoslovakia, that missionary to Africa, that missionary to El Salvador, that missionary to Mexico. And because you gave money to that missionary, Mr. Dutton, I heard the gospel of Jesus Christ and I'm in heaven today. Get the picture. It's a big one. So whatever we do on this earth, however small or big, God will reward you. Isn't that tremendous? Little old you and little old me. There is a book in heaven and God is writing down the things. I want you to be motivated to do things for the glory of God. God will bless you. Be encouraged today that everything you're doing for the kingdom of God, God is going to reward you. I bless you today in Jesus' name. Bye-bye.